Hey everyone, I'm Matt. Welcome back to another video. Today, I am super excited. We're taking a look at one of the best designed interiors of a fifth wheel that I think I've ever seen. This is a 2021 Primetime Crusader Model 335RLP. We are gonna take a look at the outside features first, then the inside features, then. We're gonna give you three things we love about this fifth wheel and three things we dislike about it. We're starting in 3, 2, 1. Hey everyone again, welcome back to another video. My name is Matt from Matt's and Will's RV Reviews Towables. It's the world's only channel giving you three things we love and three things we don't love about every travel trailer, fifth wheel, and toy hauler. And again today, I am super excited to be taking a look at this beautiful Primetime Crusader. But before I begin, I would like to say hi to Will. Hey Will!
Hey guys!
How's it going, partner?
It's going good. Like you said, Matt, this is like one of the best interiors, I think.
Yeah.
You know, for like this class of fifth wheel.
Yeah, they're really knocking it out of the park.
It's something new and different. And we sell Primetime at all 13 locations.
So. Yep, very, very exciting.
Yep.
It's great time to be selling Primetime. Will, let's begin. Model is Crusader 335RLP, but the actual tip-to-tip length of this fifth wheel is 35 feet 11 inches. The dry weight is 10,632 pounds. And Will, do you know this tongue weight?
I do not.
Neither do we. It's not on the specs of the website. Probably going to be around 2,500 pounds. You're going to need a 3/4 ton truck for this.
Yep. Okay?
Right up here, we have a nice, beautiful painted fiberglass front cap. Crusader, Primetime, very nice. We have your LED lights right there and everything. And then right here, we do have a limper component pin box, okay? Coming on, underneath here, this is where you would have a little bit of storage. Not bad. All right. Your propane tanks are gonna be right here. And this does have 6-point electric leveling jacks, okay? Right here's a D-ring where you can tie down your puppy while you're at your campsite. And then this is very big, very nice, and very impressive storage right here. You can see the aluminum framing. You got USB power and coax if you want a TV to watch on the outside. Really, really nice storage, and it is slam latch doors. We do have power right here. And then we do have not one, but two huge power awnings with LED lights. Will? Let's take a look at them when they're all the way out.
All right.
Two very big, very huge power awnings with LED lights. As you can tell, it's a little windy, so we're gonna get these awnings back in.
All right.
Great. And then, come on down here, Will.
Okay.
We do have these nice slipper component solid steps. This doesn't say, but it does have the heated enclosed underbelly. And then look at this.
America.
Oh, hell yeah, beer opener right as you walk in. Do you have speakers on the outside here? And then look at these tires, Will. They're the Trailer Kings. I love those. ST235-80R16. And you do have your Dexter axles right there. Look at that axle. I haven't seen that before.
What is it? I can't see.
There's like a little like airbag in between or something.
Oh, yeah.
That's very nice. And it does come with the TPS monitoring system as well.
Cool.
Finishing up, coming around the backside, we do have a nice bumper for your stinky slinky, spare tire carrier. It is prepped for a Furion backup camera. If you want a Furion backup camera, you can use our link below. And then look at this receiver hitch. That looks like it's only rated for 100 to 200 pounds.
Yeah, probably.
That, what do they call that, a level
150.
2 hitch? 150. What do they call it, a level 2 hitch or a level 1 hitch?
Something like that, I forget what they call it.
Yeah, it's definitely the smaller one. Also, we do have a one-piece TPO roof. Will, let's go up there and take a look.
All right.
Here we go now. Okay, up here on the roof, you can see it's a nice one-piece walkable TPO roof. Not one, but two air conditioning units. I love that. There and there is opening for max air fans. And then right there's your WineGuard digital antenna.
Here we go now.
If you haven't already, make So you smash that thumbs up button. What do the RV salesmen go take his fat ass up on the roof? Show you what features the roof has to offer.
Nobody.
Finishing up. 50 amp unit. There's the power cord right there. On the way down. Here's where you dump your tanks. Very nice position.
Yeah.
Water heater right there. Here's your water hookup. City water connection, black tank flush, outdoor shower, potable water fill.
Potable.
The other side of that storage. And here's your controls for your auto leveling. And then here is a propane tank. Well, Will, the outside of this fifth wheel looks great. But the inside looks even better. Let's go take a look.
All right. Oh, starting
yes,
up front.
Sorry.
All right. Starting up here, got the bedroom, the bathroom, coming down, kitchen, dining area, and living area.
Now, well, before we begin, I want to take a second to thank our sponsor, MyWaggle. You've heard us talk about MyWaggle for the past few weeks, and listen, it is, if you have pets, you're going to want one. It is an RV pet digital thermostat reader that reads humidities, temperature, and power. So, if you go camping with your dog and you leave him in the RV while you're at the sunny beach and you lose power, it's going to send you a text message notification. The best part about that is when you're on the beach, you don't always have Wi-Fi. That's why it does it with the Verizon network, so you get a text message. So it makes you aware that it's getting too hot or you lost power. Beach time's over, throw that towel on because it's time to get back to your puppy. So if you have a pet that you go camping with you, make sure you check out our friends MyWaggle. We have a custom link below where we already did the negotiate for you and you get a fantastic price.
That's right.
Will.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Sure is.
The whole thing. Look at this.
Oh yeah, I forgot.
Oh, I love
the zebra
that.
Shades.
These are so
cool. Oh, you got
cool.
caught.
Yep. These are so cool. I love that. When it works properly.
There you go.
There you go.
You just gotta hold it straight. No. Oh. Look, you see how you're pulling on this side?
Yeah.
Just keep it even.
Oh.
And like that.
Very nice. Very, very, very nice. I love that. Beautiful cabinetry above. Transparent doors. White cabinetry with the gold fixtures. It looks beautiful, huh?
Really does.
Nice big windows, open and bright. And then here you do have a tri-cushion sofa, a light gray, a water wickening material, and it does come out to make a bed. And then over here, we have the Allure collection. Nice seats, USB theater seats, okay? You pull this back. Very nice. And well, look at me, I'm a hot, sweaty mess. It's been a long day, and I really love, I could come here and just kick back and be comfortable. No cabinets above, you have these lights. Again, it just makes this a relatively small fifth wheel, makes it big and light and bright in here. Very comfortable. Okay? And then directly across from the theater seats is this TV entertainment center. You do have storage above, okay? And then one of my favorite features is this right here. Oh, stupid. Stupid placement before.
You gonna sing to us? Oh, you don't have any songs for this?
I got a Get Low song. Get low. So with the push of a button, you can put the TV all the way down where you can see the window. You have a Furion sound bar there and a nice fireplace that helps produce heat. And then over here, look what they're doing. I love this. The booth table setup. Very nice, big and comfortable. Again with the seat, it's a little straight up. It's not the most super comfortable, but with how far those chairs, with that being a smaller theater seat. The bigger people would actually be on that side, which is nice. You got this table right here, and again, just the big windows really opens it up, makes it light and bright in here. Well, it's now time for the MSRP. You can tell it's the end of the day, right?
Yep.
Oh, yeah. MSRP on this fifth wheel here is $69,033 MSRP. Sale prices, you can see there, we don't currently have a sale price, and it's not a problem. Because it's 2021, we can't advertise the sale price. But, well, I know we'd be able to get everybody a lot better sale price because we sell primetime at all 13 of our locations. Will, tell everybody what to do.
They can call, they can text, they can email, they can FaceTime.
Hey, 301-906-0962. Or mattsrvreviews@gmail.com. Send me an email. Or the best thing to do is go to mattsrvreviews.com. There you'll see three contact me tabs. If you're ready to buy this RV or any RV, click tab number one. That takes you to General RV, and somebody from my team will get you the best price in America. If you have questions about this RV, not a problem. Click tab number two. That sends me and Will an email back to you within 24 to 48 hours. Or if it's just a generalized fan question, click that third tab. And Will, it doesn't matter if somebody clicks tab three, two, or one. What's the one thing that every tab has in common?
They're going to get the best price in America.
No, Will, do not move.
Look at Will's face. All right, Will, come on. Let's continue.
Well, stop farting.
All right. Where are we starting at?
We'll start right here. Right around this stove and oven area. So you have a nice storage here and above the microwave and on the other side.
Very nice.
Nice regular microwave. Uh-huh. I don't think this one's a convection, but it's nice and big.
Yes.
Like that.
Very big.
So this is just a backsplash, even though it looks realistic.
Uh-huh.
I do like that window there, and I love these nice big four-burner Insignia cooktops and ovens here.
Turkey tested.
Turkey approved.
Very nice.
It's got a little bit of storage there.
Yes, sir.
And over here.
Good storage.
And then over here, you do have a nice big Norcold two-way refrigerator freezer. Works off of both electric or propane.
Very nice.
Right behind me, you got
wow,
a nice big pantry here.
Wow, very nice. Open up some of those, brother.
Okay. Got
wow,
some right there, some tall storage.
Yeah, oh wow.
That's where you put the parents' drinks. Nice little small counter space there.
It's such a beautiful RV.
It is, yeah. I just love the colors that they use in here.
Speaking of, what else do we love?
I love this nice butcher block countertop.
Mm.
So, in the last house that I flipped, we did this. We did a butcher block countertop on the island.
Oh,
it turned
okay.
out really nice. Spray faucet here.
Nice light fixture up there.
Yeah.
Whisper quiet air conditioning unit.
Nice single bowl sink here with the covers. And then over here. Got nice storage below the sink.
Mm-hmm.
And a couple drawers here.
Wow.
And there.
Perfect. It's now time for the tall test, Will. Oh, no, wait. We got more.
Oh, yeah.
But wait, there's more.
A little bit of storage up there and on your control panel.
Yep, not a ton.
And a little more down here.
Very nice.
All right, let's see.
Wow, pretty good for a mid-pro.
Yeah, I'll tell you, they could have screwed it up doing what we've run into in a lot of the others is with the placement of that skylight.
Yep.
But they put it in a good spot. There's plenty of room.
Seal of approval.
Bing!
Very nice. Right over here is where you would put the towels. Okay. Good, good. Medicine cabinet right there. Okay. Nice sink. Nice sink. Storage underneath. All right, now time for toilet test part two. Or no, part one.
Part one.
It's been a long day.
Yeah.
It's hot. Will, this is a prime poop position. Bing! Very nice.
Yep.
And then finishing up in the master bedroom, we have a nice king size bed with the Kit Kat headboard. I love that. Also, what I love about that is the fact that you're getting three windows. Very nice. Look at the slide out with those contrasting Kit Kat corners to kind of match that headboard. Did you notice that?
I did, yeah.
Yeah, I like that. Very nice big walk-in closet here,
Brad. Wow.
You know, here's where you would put your washer and dryer. Really big closet and everything.
With washer and dryer would go here, right?
Yes, yes, yes. And then if you back up, there's some nice doors right here. Very nice. Good height in the bedroom too for me. If you guys look at Will, he's almost hitting, but not quite.
Yeah, it's doable for a bedroom.
Yep. And then we got dresser drawers right here. Privacy blinds. And then here, we do have storage underneath the bed.
Very nice.
Well, Will, that's it. That's the review. That's the Primetime Crusader. Now, before everybody leaves, it's now time we give you three things we love about the Primetime and three things we just don't like about it. Will, what do we do first?
Three things we dislike.
Okay. We're going to start right here. Okay. No, I got two.
Okay.
This carpet.
Oh, yeah, that was my one.
Carpet, carpet, carpet. We don't like
and
carpet.
It's out there as
well. Yep, and it's out there underneath the dinette. We do not like that. We're not a fan of that and never will be a fan of that. That is number one. Number two is this button for the TV. Now, this sounds stupid, but to go like this and like to be pushing the button as the TV's going up and down, I promise you, it doesn't seem like that big of a deal, but to be standing here for 45 seconds to make that work is really, really stupid, and I hate that. That is number two. And then, Will, number three?
I don't know. They did a good job with this.
They really did. They really did. Hmm. Was there anything outside?
I don't think so. That's what I was just thinking about.
They did the double awning?
They did, yep.
They had the storage. You know what I will say? Nope, they're doing 6-point leveling.
Here's what I will say.
Talk to me.
It's kind of reaching a little bit, but I do hate that hitch.
No, I haven't seen that.
Yeah.
Now you need to buy an adapter.
Yeah, just do the regular hitch.
Right, what's up with that? Very good. Yeah. Everybody else is doing the 3-inch receiver or whatever, or the 2-inch, whatever it's called. That's a joke.
It is, yeah.
Great point, Will. That's number three. So that's three things we don't like about it. Now it's time for three things we love about this fifth wheel.
Okay.
Come on inside, Will.
America.
So, one, I'm going to start off.
Okay.
I'm not going to do that because I know that's going to be yours. I love the furniture. I love the cabinetry. I love the look. I love this. I think this looks beautiful. I like the gold handles and everything. This is just such a beautiful, beautiful fifth wheel. And I think they did a killer job in the living room area.
Yep.
That is one. Number two.
Okay, mine's definitely going to be this televator. Because I love that they did this. I feel like it's so easy to do and not a lot of manufacturers do it.
And the fact that you get that window, yep.
Yeah. I mean, if you do the televator, you have to do the window.
And you got to put the button in a better position.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's two. And then to wrap it all up, well, real nice and easy. Butcher block. This looks fantastic.
Yeah. That's it?
Do we need to say more?
No, it does look nice. Combo that just with all the colors too, really.
I mean, even this. I mean, everything they did in here. Primetime. What's up?
Yep, exactly.
Well, Will, that's it. That's the review. Thank you guys, absolutely everybody, so much for watching. If you guys have any questions about this fifth wheel, please call us, text us, send us an email. It is mattsrvreviews@gmail.com or 301-906-0962. That's my personal cell number, or the best thing to do is go to mattsrvreviews.com. If you're in the market for a nice mid-profile fifth wheel like this, in a few seconds, we're going to put the Crusaders competition right here and here. Will, is there anything you want to say?
Of course. All right, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Remember to, if you're interested in my Waggle, we have that link down in the description below to get you guys a nice, good discount. And again, it's so important if you have pets.
Yes.
Make sure to leave in the comments. Let us know three things you like, three things you dislike
This is our last video here in Virginia.
Yep.
Should we tell them where we're going next?
Yeah.
All right, so next in like 3 or 4 weeks for us, but 2 days for you guys.
Yep.
We will be in Michigan, probably Wixom.
Wixom, Michigan.
Yep. So I'm excited to go there. I've never been to Michigan.
Yep.
And we will be hitting some really, really good units so we don't have south.
Yep.
So definitely tune in 2 days.
Perfect.
Make sure to also smash the thumbs up button and subscribe.
Thank you guys, absolutely everybody, so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.